Hello everyone, and thank you for attending for today's webinar about VisiMix new release of Center Impeller. I recommend to stay until the end of the webinar when we will present you the special price for today's participant in the webinar. And now I will invite Mr. Moshe Ben-Tulila, VisiMix mixing expert, to give us the webinar about the off-center impeller.
Okay, thank you very much to be in our meeting today. I'm very happy to be with you and to introduce a new software that talking about the off-center impellers in the way, but step by step, to release to you a complete a picture of all the stirrer vessels that you can have in your tank with very good and proof models that can help you in order to develop and manufacture your products to the market. So VisiMix is very proud to introduce this new feature, this new product that is off-center impellers. As you know, we're located in Jerusalem in Israel, and we'd very like to share with you this new model that's based in the existing knowledge in the company, but we release as a product because we are feeling that this field is very important in your work. So this is a new release. You are invited to be here with us. It's today now. We start. People that are participants here, we will release to you after the conversation with you, of course, and a special prize for the participants in the presentation. So we talk about off-center impellers that you can see here in the left bottom corner of my screen, that it can be this kind of off-center or from the bottom that are very popular now, specific in aseptic equipment for the aseptic condition and pharmaceutical industry in formulations. What we do today is to have few minutes about the company, because some of you were many people here attended, so some of you would know about the company. We'll talk 2 minutes about the company. After that, we will describe a new version and, of course, open the software, show to you what is the feasibility, how to inputs fit to the software, and which kind of outputs we can generate. If you have any question, please feel free to write in the chat. It will be difficult for us to hear your questions, because we are many attendees. So I will try to answer your question during the presentation when I read the chat that you sent to me. And by the end, if we continue to have questions, you are invited to send me an email, is to reply in the same email you received today in reminding you the participation of this meeting. Okay, so VisiMix is a unique software, as you know well, because we are combining between empirical models, but we are solving the momentum balance of our equipment. So we combine between the numerical methods to solve the differential equations that describe the momentum balance in combination with empirical data required in order to be sure that every number that we are releasing is according to the real situation we have in our tank. It is for every kind of application in the software. We talk about semi-empirical models. Everyone can use the software, because by the end, we reduce all our inputs to the very sensitive input without losing any sensitivity in the results and, of course, in the influence of the mixing of the process. So if we talk about only correlations, or we talk about very high level of numerical calculations, we are talking about to be very viable to you, very simple to you, to reduce the input data required. It facilitates everyone and becomes very significant the results we are relating to you. This is the reason that we are unique in the market and when we have a very, very intensive and high value to every company that have a confidence about the result and proof by their experience. We can visualize results, of course, but the main important point, we are releasing you numbers that describe in a multidimensional phenomena that is mixing, how to connect between the mixing and the process. So what will be the influence of the mixing on the process in the real sensitivity? No very high level of assumptions and simplifications that will lose the point, and also deeply an expertise that required for the CFD products that, of course, you can use in order to complete your knowledge to do more deeply academic study. Our products allow significant saving and cost by drastically reducing the need for trial and error. And the reason is that the results are fast and you can implement at the same time, generate the experiment and the knowledge required for your activities. That, of course, is not mixing. Your activities and your goal is your process, is your real life. So we are trying to combine all of this very sophisticated way in a very simple interface to you. The software was developed in Russia by Professor Leonid Braginsky. They came to Israel after there was the principal engineer, and he was in Leningrad Institute. He was in charge to be sure that the new process in the industry will run in a good way. The only way to do it is to generate models that are describing the main important change you are doing during the scale-up, during the parameterization, and transfer technology data to other side, that it is the environment that you are providing through the mixing to your process. So manage your own experience, part of our R&D customer support department. So any question you have not only the pure number, you have a complete and extensive expertise that we add to our customers. When you are a customer, you receive a complete support that everyone is enjoying. BCMix is based in physical models supported by the empirical data in the way that we solve momentum balance depending on existing equipment. The phenomena is of flow in the vessel is taking into account using many theories of flow, mixing next of Prandtl, Kolmogorov. The point is that we adapt these general theories in a stirrer vessel tanks with a vast way of experiment that generate a model that is our own property. And of course, you can use it. It's a product for you. Use it in order to generate a relevant input to the company. And after we consider all of this and we solve the velocity, you know it is the base for many mixing parameters that can be the difference in the result that you're getting in yield quality and operation, like gas holdup, solid distribution, bubble size, drop size, and many others. Mass transfer coefficient, heat transfer coefficient, and many of them that exactly the parameters required in order to generate an input, a good input. Companies working with us, you can see, many of them using the software in global licenses, in a single place, according to the business plan you have, we're very flexible on it. Victor Atiemovenk, that I hope is with us because he's visiting always our team, is advising to use in different ways the software. This was the mixing expert in Dow Chemical, with very good expertise and very good common and good sense about how to connect this sophisticated unit operation that sometimes we forgot according to what we learned from him and how to implement it in the way that will be efficient and good and you will have a relevant results. As you can see, we are releasing from time to time different kinds of products. So this will be the new product of center that trying to cover some part of the industry that it was seemed to be not covered. Really was covered, but it is in a simple way to do when we release for you a product. So the product that we are releasing now is giving you another stage in order to try to generate work. You can see many testimonials in our website. You can visit every one of them. The companies show us how sometimes simple considerations that we need to take were enough in order to save a lot of money, that it by the end is giving you the justification to implement this knowledge, because by the end, this phenomena is happening in your town if we want or not. So if we will consider it and try to evaluate in a better way, of course we will take in advance this knowledge as a part of the knowledge of the process and save time of money for the company, our job will be more relevant. The software can be used in different sizes, from the lab to the design and the production, of course, to justify what you are doing in your company, because by the end, this is a phenomena that happened in your time that you need to characterize anyway. And I can tell you, you, the people that are here, you are the only one that will be able to do it, because by the end, you have the expertise of this. The meaning of this, you are thinking about the equipment, you are thinking about the process, and you are the bridge between them. So when you have a very base, very good base, that will be the software calculation and the expertise, you will be able to generate a good yield, quality, and operation of your process. So use it in different ways, take to advance this knowledge in the R&D to go to design and production. And of course, use it the way that if you will be able to identify what is the situation, try to do it at very small scale, scale as possible, in order to mimic the same range of work that you will mimic, you will have in the production step, and set up your lab equipment in the way that you will identify the mixing parameters that will be good for you. If you have more support about it, we're providing to you all of this support for all the software for every engineer. And so we have e-tutorials, personal ongoing justification. Of course, we're doing seminar on site, and every follow-up and question you have for us is a pleasure. So until now, the last release was 3D, generic hydrofoils and alternative impellers. And we have more than 250 companies that are working with this. And now this is a new release. Now we are implementing the same kind of model with some adjust. We adjust the model in the way that you will be able to use at any position your tank in consideration in different ways. And it is normally that happen in some formulation companies, in some companies that don't like to have baffles, and many others of activities that you can mention in the software. So it's the same, you can see here, it's the same model, base VC mix, but we are now connecting with different positions. And of course, for this, we did adapt, we adapt the results and the model to the configuration. The way that we can work, we have off-center impellers. So if we work last in our normal software with a center impeller that have many, many advantages, okay? And we release after that some kind of different impellers in the same shaft. You can see in the left corner bottom. Now we can add, use these two platforms, and with adaptation and adjust of the model that we have, we are able to use in different configurations. So we have off center, not in the center, with some distance from the center. We have some shaft inclination in one plane, okay? You see, this plane is center, but this plane is not center. Or in two planes, okay? You can see here the off-center in two planes. And from the bottom, that this is very very popular now for aseptic equipment, I have many experience about it. So the off-center, we are releasing, of course, in parts, because we try to start to work with the hair, that it is the hydrodynamic point of view, and after that, to implement in the different unit operations. So the first release of the program allows for entering of mixing devices with one or two impellers, identical or different, vertical and inclined heat entering shaft, bottom entering mixing device with a single impeller. And the program will give you, as an output, main parameters of hydrodynamics, turbulence, when we talk about turbulence regime, okay, local mixing, mixing times, and the heat transfer coefficients, not only the heat transfer group of parameters that normally we release, it will be a variable num. If you want to work with solid, liquid, 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 gas, liquid, and more on this, this is a procedure simple to do, like we do normally with different impeller software. We hope that during the time we will close this gauge and we will provide to you the next step. It, of course, one of the many important issues that we are working now in order to release more simple way to work. With this base, we can calculate everyone that you can think, but it will be in two stages. And now I would like to open the software and show to you how to input, how to get results in some way, because by then this is the this is that you want to see. So what we have is the follow. You let's start from the beginning. The off-center impeller, you have this. Now we will maybe check the icon, but it will be close to a same, because you can see VC Mix of Center 2019. The thing, the first to do is like every VC Mix software is a project new. And now we need to give a name. The name will be Offset. Okay. Now when you click save, okay, Offcenter 1. Offcenter 1, okay. And now when you click save, the software will start to use the minimum required data in order to start to calculate as always. So let's start with elliptical elliptical bottom. And let's use some data that we have in our website. Sorry, the diameter will be 1,800. The volume of the tank will be 5,200. And you remember well that we fill the data that will can be calculated automatically. And let's say that in my equipment, I use 4,000 liter. So I click in the gray zone. You see we have the drawing of equipment, exactly what we did before that. Now, in our case, I will use buffers. You can have with no buffer, it's okay. I will show to you in other, in the second example. So click OK. And now we have to fit four buffers, exactly the same what we had in our typical example in our website. This is the height of my tank. The distance from the bottom, 450 millimeter. The distance from the wall will be 50. And the radius, the angle between the baffle and the R axis will be 0. We click OK. We need now the density and viscosity of the media. So we will use 1050, and we will use Newtonian media. In our example, I use 2. We click OK. Now you see new impeller. Where is located my impeller? And now we talk about to click new impeller, click add impeller, and now you can use different kinds of impeller that we have normally in the software. I use this turbine. You can use alternative impellers for every impeller you can imagine it with the power number. But in this case, now we have here our impeller. Now, take care that we talk here about is we talk about the distance here from the end of the shaft, because once we have the end of the shaft, in the next step, we need to localize this shaft in some point. This is the only difference we have from our normal VC Mix software. So let's use 600 and 450, and distance from the number of blade 6, and pinch angle of the blade 90, and the distance from the width of the blade 125, and the length of the blade 150 millimeter. Okay. And the distance from the end of the shaft will be 150 millimeter. So when we click in the gray zone, you see we have some change a little according to the dimensions. And when we click OK, we have this one. Let's say we have only one impeller. We can use more, two, three, to one, two impellers with no problem. We'll use only one in order to compare to other examples we have. Now, we have the rotational speed in our data. The rotational speed will be 125, and the power, the motor power we'll use will be 7.5 but 7.5 but. Okay, perfect. Now when we click OK, now we can select the off send. As you can see here, we have to select different kind of configurations. In my case, I will use this one. Okay, you can use this one. You can see we are changing here, or this one, or this one. In our case, I will use this one. And now the high, you see this will be the high, this will be the radius, and you need one plane to play with the angle. So the high of this will be 450. The radius will be 150. Yes, and the angle will be about 70 degrees. So once I click here, you will see here the picture according to iFit now. When we click OK, we are ready to start to calculate. Okay, what we calculate, exactly what we calculate before that. You remember, we can calculate the main hydrodynamics, we can calculate the velocity as a function of the position. Okay, of course it will be a little different than the distribution we had in other equipments. We can calculate the mixing power, torque, and force applied to the baffle, vortex parameters with no problem. We can go and calculate turbulence, energy for dissipation as a function of the position of the zone that we are around in Perel, and so on. And of course, we can calculate the main period of circulation, micro mixing time, the same as we did normally. Now, let's say that we would like to compare with the bottom. You remember, we have clone. When we click clone, now it will be, I will give a new name, okay? And when we give the new name, the meaning of this, I am generating the same data with different name. Now we have exactly the same data, but the name will be bottom. And from here, we can do some changes. So I will go to edit input in the device. I will change the impeller configuration. Let's go to edit input, impeller scheme. Instead, this one I will use from the bottom. Okay, it's very common, this kind of equipment. And now, the only thing that I need to know, what will be the distance between the center and the position of the equipment, the new impeller. So I will use, let's say, 350 millimeters from the center. So you see we are now located here, and now we are able to calculate exactly the same. So we can calculate the hydrodynamic of the systems, we can calculate the energies of dissipation, we can calculate the mixing times, okay? Micro mixing time of main period of circulation. And now when you click tile, you can see all of them together. In order to give you some idea about which kinds of results we generate, let's calculate, for instance, two. Let's calculate the main hydrodynamics, okay, and the energy for dissipation for the bottom. And when you remember to jump between the impellers, I only need to go to the name of the last menu, so this is the picture. Now let's go and calculate the energy of the dissipation here and the main hydrodynamic parameters. Tile, close this one, and now you see these two systems together. So you see a little differences between them. Let me put them together. This will be easier to compare. Okay, so the numbers are a little different. And if you remember well, this example is the normal example that I tried to present to you at the beginning. And when you go to turbulent, it's exactly the same equipment in the center. And when you calculate the hydrodynamic of the system and you calculate the energy for dissipation, okay, now you see these numbers that you can compare with these numbers, and you see how is different, because the position have some correction to do that now is ready to use in your site with no problem. Continue to do exactly the same way to work. Feed data, generate results, and go ahead with these results. I have some questions here that I would like to answer. Waze Jean, hello, how are you? I have some discussion. Distance from the shaft end, yes, this that you need to do at the beginning when you have the characterization of the impeller. You need to go to the distance from the end of the shaft. I will show to you, okay? If you go to the end of the shaft, okay? If you go to the end of the shaft, you see here, let me do the edit here. You see, it is the distance from this top, from this bottom to here. If I change it, for instance, 300, you see that it is from the end of the shaft to here. After that, if you need to localize your impeller in the tank, this will need more. So when we go to the edit input and impeller, installation scheme, here you need to give me what is this height and this distance, this H1 and R1. The second question that we had, let me check where we are the questions. Sorry, I lost your questions. Where we have questions? Yes. Okay, sorry. The second question is coming from Nuno Loza. How are you, Nuno? Nice to hear you here. Can we use different impellers in this software? No, this is completely different release because the model is different. As this case with different impellers, yes, it's the same way to work, but it's completely different model. Mr. Jeffrey Maxwell, nice to meet you. What does the heat transfer to the batch look like? It is exactly the same. I will show to you how we can do it, okay? If you go here to, let's say, semi-batch or batch, you see the temperature of the media, the temperature of the wall, heat transfer coefficient, all of them will calculate. Of course, we will need more characterization about the media you are throwing to the jacket, the material, so what is the building material of your tank, because you have heat transfer that you have to take in consideration, and the properties of the media as a function of the temperature. All of these data we need to fit. It is not complicated, which is 2-3 steps more. You had a second question here. Instead, in the heat generated and temperature rise in dispersing pigment with the high shear rate blend. Yes. When we talk about it, we have to take in consideration what is the heat you are implementing to your tank. So what is really the heat, but what validation cases have you considered to know these results are representative? And what is the whole? We have a huge, about 30 years of data validated in our models in order to show it. Part of them are released in our website with, if you want, I think I sent to you, I will send to you again. The validation file, that is a document about 40 pages for every one of the parameters. Some calculations we did, and some measurements were done by papers that not related to us, to be sure that we are answering this kind of answers. Okay? Bilik Igor, nice to meet you. I remember you from UCB. Some new impellers are added compared to the previous version. The way that we did it is in order in alternative impeller, because you know the manufacturer of equipment have a lot of shapes. But by the end, we can, according to the shape, advise what will be the power number, or you can ask from them. And once you have the power number that is, of course, not constant, is something that is changing. But if you have one power number that is a nominal power number, from this, whatever to calculate what you want with no problem. There is a lack on published validation data. I don't think so. You can visit our website and we can discuss separately. But we have a lot of data in our website ready to use. Hi, do Sriram, we meet you a few hours ago. Nice to meet you. Hi, do these off-center impairments have application in the pharmaceutical? Of course, pharmaceutical industry, all the companies that are doing some kind of cream, some kind of formulation, syrup, even drops for eyes, they are using because they are very afraid about the buffers, so they don't want to have buffers. Accept it. And they will be in the bottom, okay, with no shaft because cleaning issues. So they are using in this way many companies. We have a lot of demand, and for this reason, we translate this huge data we had in a product for everyone because it was very difficult to transfer everyone this expertise. So we convert it in a commercial product. Show us the hydrodynamic scheme generated in the three cases. You have simulated that we have until now because we wanted to release it very fast. Okay. Thank you very much. It was Victor. Victor, nice to hear you and to hear from you. Yes, that we have until now at this step, we are released only the numbers. The 3D, of course, we can show. It is very nice to see. Okay. So when we do the 3D file and when we open the viewer, it is a very let's say different way to see, but it is exactly mixing. Okay, so I am opening here, and now what you see is if I start from the beginning, you see flow elements that you can of course control. The position of the flow elements. This is from the bottom of the tank, from the wall, in some point. Okay, here, and what you will see here is what happened with your flow elements moving in the tank. That is exactly the mixing. You are trying to connect between different fluid elements in your tank. So when you click around, you see how this is spread in the bottom. It is only entering in the center. The dots here, the blue, the white, and the black, and the red is going up and down. I can see it you show you in this way. It is from the center to the wall and up and down. It is too, you can see it is too radial, so it is difficult to go up when you are down. Once you are up, you're going up and down to some level, and you can play with it and show many to people that are not familiar with mixing how, what will happen, and many times there will be a very good tool to show them and to explain them what is behind the some no simple behavior they have in their tank. Thank you very much, Victor. Okay, you have another question. Repeat the calculation for the off-center case without that. Okay, very good. I will do it. I will take out the buffers and we'll do it again. If I come to the off-center, okay, and let's say in this tank, I will take out the buffers, okay? So I will clone again in order to generate another one, different color, and simple. Go your buffer and take out, no buffers. Now we'll calculate, for instance, hydrodynamic of the system and energy of dissipation at different places. Let's put them together. And now I will take out this, okay? Wonder to be, okay. And now this is without buffers. You see how different is the energy of dissipation. It is one order of magnitude less, okay? And the power is different, the average. What happened in the bulk is completely different in different stage. And if I compare it with the turbulent, okay, you can see here different numbers. So it is sensitive, it's providing to you a different way. This is the reason that you have this kind of equipment. And with this basic knowledge, you will be able to combine to the phenomena you see in your development, the beginning of the way, include this knowledge at the beginning of the way to have a clear concept of your whole process and not part of them that normally It is the reason to deviations in the next step that generate sometimes millions of dollar loss because we are generating impurities, no good particle size, no good mass transfer. Typical examples that we can play again and again. I would like to progress to some conclusion of this part, okay? So after we define it and I show to you how it's working, the conclusion is that we want to provide to you a tool that gives you a better understanding of your process because it is happening anyway. And our instruction in this process engineer or chemical engineer is exactly this, is to try to include this phenomena that transport to the process because our goal is the process. So we will reduce dramatically our activities in the Skylab and manufacturing because we are focusing ourselves what really is the change, is the main difference between the scenarios and how to control them. The software is simple to use. I show to you a few minutes. We can evaluate what we want. And again, VisiMix is a result of systematic model of mixing that is unique in the world. It is not solution of mathematical equation alone. It is not only empirical data that we can collect for every textbook. We are connecting between them and adding the expertise of a team of people that worked more than 30 years in order to gap the problems from the transfer, the knowledge from lab to production, or even from site to site. You know, it can be multiple surprises that you can avoid once you are controlling your basic, your environment. Through this environment, you are manufacturing your process. We have another product that database and VS Excel that is transferring the data to Excel to do a very simple way. And it seems to be very simple, but it's important because when you are sitting in the meeting, you are talking with people in the production, in the management, in R&D, in the QA/QC. And once you put in the table what is really the difference and you are able to do the calculation in the table, okay, and show them how will be the range of work, the difference of the parameters on the same table, we will focus our discussion on what is the consequence of this change and not discuss about if it will be difference or not. And it is enough sensitive, enough simple, but in other sides, sophisticated and giving you exactly what you are requiring at this field. So, for people that come to the for this release during all the 2019, the price per year is $7,500. Of course, you can contact us info@visimix.com. And for you that you have the passion to hear you, to hear me, and I hope it was not so boring. For this, you save $2,000 because you have a passion to hear me 45 minutes, and I hope it will be a good return on invest on your 45 minutes. So you save until now $2,500 once you will contact us. We have the list, so we will identify you, and with small chat with you, we will be able to provide to you more data about it to grant some of your specific data in order to give you more ammunition, more tools to discuss to your manager together to start to work with this kind of software. So thank you very much again. It is a pleasure always when I'm coming to this kind of meeting to meet you together in the same time, people that I very like and I love. And in this way, we are trying to solve more, another one, and another one step, because by then it's a very sophisticated unit operation and very important one, and it is not possible to reduce it in a few correlations or only mathematical solution. Thank you very much for your time. If you have more questions, I would like to see, but more of this, normally we are answering these questions by email for your way. So thank you very much for your time. I hope you enjoy, and we will send to you this presentation. And of course, we invite you to come here and to contact and to start to use this new release. Have a good time. Bye-bye. Marcy asked me about what is the release time. The release date is about the end of April. In 20 days from now. So thank you very much. Have a good time a day. Thank you, Barbara Fumik, for your comments.